Hi, welcome to our second part of arithmetic series where we're going to be focusing on real world problems. So in our last video, we talked about what arithmetic series and sequences were and how to find those sums. So now we're going to apply them in our real world applications. So let's begin. A video game tournament in which gamers compete in multiple games and accumulate an overall score pays the top 20 finishers. First place receives $5,000. Second place receives $4,800, third place receives $4,600, and so on. How much total prize money is awarded? Well, first thing I'm going to do is highlight the most important information in this paragraph. So the top 20 finishers or finalists or placeholders, however you want to call that, is a value I would highlight. The first place receiving $5,000, second place $4,800, and third place receiving $4,600. Is something else I would highlight. And finally, the question itself, how much total prize money is awarded? So let's break up those various things into their mathematical equivalents. The top 20 finishers means that they've given me the number of terms I want to know about. So from n equals 1 to n equals 20. If they tell me that first place receives $5,000, they've actually told me my first term. So a sub 1 equals $5,000. Second place means a sub 2 equals 4,800, a sub 3 equals 4,600. To find the total prize money, I'm looking for a sum value. So my sum, specifically it's S sub 20 is what we're looking for. So let's plug in what we know. But before we can plug in what we know, first we have to figure out the given information. Did they give us any hidden information, any information I can solve by just looking at the givens or manipulating the givens? So looking at the information they gave me, I can immediately figure out that this looks like an arithmetic sequence. So there's a D value, a common difference between each of my terms. And I went ahead and calculated it and figured out that the D value is negative 200. What about any equations that I have that can fit all of this? Well, to find a sum for an arithmetic series, we have two equations. So I'm going to use the equation that looks like this, the equation that's popped up on my screen. The one that includes n, the first value, and d. Not the one that includes my final value, because then I would have to solve every single term, or I'd have to solve the explicit formula to solve the last one. It's an extra set of steps, and so it's not necessarily the smartest method for solving this one. It could be solved doing that one, but it's not the most efficient method. So I'm going to plug in what I know. I know the n value is 20, so I plug in 20 in both of the n value locations. I plug in a sub 1, and I plug in the d value. Now I finish my solve. 20 minus 1 is 19. 20 divided by 2 is 10. 2 times 5,000 is 10,000. 9 times negative 20 or negative 200 is negative 3,800. 1,000 minus 3,800 is 6,200. Times 10 is 62,000. Does that make sense? If we added 5,000 plus 4,800 plus 4,600 and so on and so forth, would we get a large value like 62,000? It does make sense. So I'm going to put it back into its sentence form. They gave us the stem sentence, how much total prize money is awarded. So I'm going to use that sentence. The total prize money awarded at the video game tournament is $62,000. Ta-da! Let's do a question that's a little bit more complicated. Carter has been collecting baseball cards since his father gave him a 20-card collection. During every month, Carter's father gives him 5 more cards than the previous month. So if in January I started with 20, in February he's going to give me 25 more. And then in March, he's going to give me 30 more cards. And then in April, he's going to give me 35 more cards. In May, 40, and so on and so forth. So he gives me 5 more cards than the previous month. He doesn't give 5 cards each time, if that makes sense how to read that sentence. In how many months will Carter reach 1,000 cards? So if I start with 20 and the next month I add 25 more and the next month I add 30 and then so on and so forth, that's how we're going to figure out this question. So let's highlight the important information. He started with 20 cards. Every month he gets 5 more. than the previous month. So that one's a little bit weird. It's what we call, we're technically working with our second differences. So that means we're actually going to be looking at a quadratic formula, and I'll show you how we're going to solve this very easily, very slowly. How many months will Carter reach 1,000 cards is the end question we're solving. So let's break that down into our mathematical terms. 20 cards is not the number of terms, it's actually the very first term. So a sub 1 is equal to 20. It's the original amount I started with. If every month I add 5 more, that is still a difference of plus 5. Again, we're dealing with something called a second difference. My GT students go further into this. And if you'd like to, you can watch the challenge video and do the challenge question. But each month you're getting 5 more than the previous month. So it's really a second difference. But we're going to deal with that just plus 5 for right now. If we want to reach 1,000 cards, we're dealing with a sum value, a sum of such n that we reach 1,000. We don't know the n value. In fact, how many months is going to be our n value? What the heck is our n? So we're going to solve for that n. Well, if I know the first term, I know the difference, I know what the sum equals, and I don't know the n, then I can use the first sum formula to help me solve this. So I go ahead and throw that first sum formula in. I plug in what I know. I know the end sum, I know the original term, and I know the second difference. I know what that plus 5 is doing each time. So I go ahead and solve it out as far as I can solve it, and I end up with an n squared value. Well, hey, look at that. We end up with that quadratic formula I told you that we're probably progressing towards. When we deal with second differences, we tend to be progressing towards a quadratic formula. So I'm going to solve this like a quadratic formula. I set it equal to 0. If I wanted to, I could take out a common factor of 5. And now I'm going to actually have to use a calculator to finish this solve. And I end up solving for n, getting either 16.8 or negative 23.8. Well, let's read that question one more time. And how many months will Carter reach 1,000 cards? Can he be doing this for negative 23.8 months? No. So immediately we know negative 23.8 cannot be our answer. So we know we're dealing with 16.8. But it will take Carter 16.8 months to reach 1,000 cards? What the heck is 0.8 of a month? I mean, that's going to be chaos. Even if you try to break it down into days, you know, each month has different days. There's 30, there's 31, sometimes there's 28. This year we had a 29. Welcome to leap year. So what do we have to do to that 16.8? Time can neither be negative, and because we're dealing with months, we're going to have to round. So our answer is not 16.8, but it is 17 months to reach Carter's 1,000 cards. Really, it'll be a little over 1,000 cards, but in order to reach that minimum value of 1,000 cards, he would have had to have been doing this system with his father, getting 5 more every month for 17 months. That's a lot of cards for Carter's father to be getting him every month. But anyway, so there's our closure. We just focused on real-world applications. We now understand arithmetic. In our next two videos, we're going to be focusing on geometric. If you can kind of make a guess about arithmetic versus geometric, arithmetic, we dealt with common differences. With geometric, we're going to be dealing with common ratios. So that's going to be our big new word coming up. All righty. I'll see y'all online.